हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वार्म वेलकम टू ऑल टू माय चैनल वर्ल्ड ऑफ जूलॉजी एंड वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस यूनिट वन वंडर्स ऑफ द एनिमल वर्ल्ड एंड अंडर दैट वी हैव ऑलरेडी फिनिश लास्ट पॉइंट दैट इज ब्रीडिंग एंड पेरेंटल केयर इन पाइसेस एम्फीबिया एंड नाउ वील डिस्कस द नेक्स्ट दैट इज मैमल्स पेरेंटल केयर इन मैमल्स will consider in our today's lecture. Here I would like to explain the point with respect to two animals, that is parental care in marsupials, that is marsupial animals, with respect to kangaroo and egg laying mammal, that is duckbill platypus. First we'll consider kangaroo. Here the picture of which is shown. Kangaroo with its young one, that is Joey, in the marsupium. Marsupials form a distinct group of mammals with a peculiar structure, the marsupium, a pouch or bag-like structure. It is present in most females, into which the immature young ones develop further after birth. The mammary glands with teat open into marsupium for supplying milk to the growing young ones. The marsupial eggs are very similar to that of the eggs of the reptiles and birds. The early development of the eggs in the uterus is also similar to that of the reptiles and birds. In marsupials, the young ones remain inside the body of the female for short period, and therefore young one is born which is very small, and early development takes place in the marsupium. Gestation period in kangaroo is 33 days before the neonate emerges. Usually only one joey is born at a time. The marsupial young ones are tiny at the time of the birth, each individual weighing only few milligrams, approximately 800 milligrams, and so on. The neonate reaches the pouch within 3 minutes. Immediately after birth, the young one is carried in pouch on the abdomen of its mother. The transfer of young one to pouch of the mother is done in a very interesting way. The young one immediately after birth start moving towards the nipples of the mother with the help of its forelimbs. The newly born young one is almost blind, but it somehow managed to reach the area of the nipples of the mother. It is still not clearly known how this is done by the young one. This may be because of the strong forelimbs which are developed in the young one. The forelimbs are well developed, as they help the young one to pull along the mother's belly and thus crawling to the brood pouch. It then fastens itself to one of the four teats and start feeding. Thus they develop in marsupium or pouch. The joey is in the mother's pouch for about 6 to 8 months. It continues to suckle till about 12 months. Ultimately, the young ones develop jaws and eyes and able to open its mouth. At this stage, it is able to come out of pouch of its mother and then can continue to lead independent life, which is shown in this diagram. We'll consider parental care in mammals with respect to egg-laying mammal, that is duckbill platypus. Here small platypus is shown in this diagram. Platypus is an egg-laying mammal belonging to order Monotremata. It breeds during September-October. Mating takes place in water. In 2 weeks after mating and before eggs are laid, the female platypus prepare for arrival of her young one. Mating process is shown in this diagram. And now, how parental care is taken by the female is shown in this diagram. She selects a suitable location for the nesting burrow in the roots of the tree with opening just above the water level. The nesting burrow is far more complicated than the resting burrow. The resting burrow is about 4 to 5 meters long, while the nesting burrow is up to 20 meters long with twists and turns. That is, it is more complicated than the resting burrow. She uses her tail to collect the leaves to make a nest at the end of this burrow. Before she lays his eggs, before the mother lays her eggs, she seals herself into a burrow by blocking it at the interval with the earth. This provides a safe place for the mother to incubate her eggs and raise her young ones. 2 weeks after mating, 2 to 3 grape-sized yolky eggs are laid by the female. The eggs have soft leathery shell like the reptilian eggs. Then the female incubates the eggs by folding them between her body and the tail region, which is shown in the diagram. The eggs hatch after 2 weeks of the incubation, and the female platypus remain continuously with the eggs until hatch. Means the female platypus, it remains continuously with the eggs until the hatching for the parental care. The caruncle on the head and the egg tooth help the young one in breaking the shell at the time of the birth. The female produces milk from the specialized sweat glands present on the ventral abdomen of the body, that is ventral abdominal wall, and ducts of which directly open to the patch of the skin. The young one licks the fur for its feed of the milk, since teats are lacking in this animal. Now we'll consider the summary of the lecture. I would like to summarize parental care in the mammal with respect to two animals. One, that is marsupial from the phylum Chordata, subphylum Vertebrata, and this group, that is marsupial mammals, that is pouch mammal, which is a pouch-like structure in case of the female for the further development or the for taking parental care in case of kangaroo. And the second animal is the egg-laying animal, the egg-laying mammal, that is dugbill platypus. In both these animals, the parental care is explained or studied in this lecture. Thank you for watching my video. If you like the video, like it. Share the video for the benefit of the maximum students, and subscribe my channel for the further notification of the next video. Thank you once again.